So academic integrity really boils down to honesty and fairness. We want to make sure that the playing field is even for everyone, and that students are transparent about how they're doing their assessments and how they're doing their learning. So students need to understand what it means to use generative AI and what it means to create something themselves. So if you're asking generative AI to write something for you, to reword something for you, to paraphrase something for you, to translate something for you, that is fine if it's for a learning, you know, your own learning. But if it's something that you're going to put in for an assessment, that's definitely where it crosses the line for us.
If we surrender ourselves to AI, to technology, to tech giants, to social media, to data mining and gathering, if we surrender ourselves, we lose everything that we have now that means something to us as a civilized society that wants to look forward.
You need to make sure that what you're putting in for assessment is your own work. And when you're asking generative AI to alter what you've done, that inherently changes it, so it's not your own work anymore. There is no statute of limitations for when you're putting in your assessment piece. If at some point the technology becomes better and we see that a student cheated on an assessment, we can reopen that even if they have graduated. And we have students that that has happened to, unfortunately.
Turnitin is a really great example of a tool that is being used to detect plagiarism. It's being used by students. It's a fantastic tool. I think it's something that students should be really thankful for, and I suspect we'll find new tools.
The thing that we are seeing the most is students not really understanding that they are using generative AI in some of these tools. They might go, oh, I'm just gonna use QuillBot to rearrange my writing. So I wrote it, but I'm just gonna put it into QuillBot to paraphrase it. That is generative AI use, and they are not allowed to do that unless they're given permission. Another program that is tripping up a lot of students is Grammarly Go. The standard version is generally okay at the moment, where it's kind of your typing and Grammarly gives you some suggestions on how to improve your grammar. Because it's still your work, you're still writing, you're still coming up with the ideas. But Grammarly Go is that one step more. That is the generative AI component, where there's a little box next to that says, you know, type in what you want it to write, and you prompt it. That's the line that we cross. Your unit coordinator might give you specifics in Blackboard or in the learning management system about how they want you to use it, if they are allowing you to use it. Transparency is the key of academic integrity. If you're using a tool and you can't tell your unit coordinator about it, that should be a giant red flag for you that there's a problem. So if you say, yeah, I'm using this to help with this, and I'm talking to my unit coordinator and telling them how I'm using it, fabulous. We don't have a problem here. It's about that honesty and about that transparency and making sure everybody's on the same page.